So this year we're celebrating one of the greatest milestones in the history of modern humankind, the 70th anniversary of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, something that we owe to our wonderful First Lady, Eleanor Roosevelt, who championed the idea in the United Nations of a globalist human rights where human rights were universal and that every person had the right to the inherent dignity that every person deserves, the rights to health, to alleviation of poverty, to clean water and safe food, went from charity to an enforceable right, one that every country in the world has the obligation to respect and protect. The fulfillment of human rights to global health law has been remarkable. HIV/AIDS has gone from a stigmatizing disease and a death sentence, literally, to a treatable disease that respects individual dignity. Tobacco control has saved millions of lives, protecting the most disadvantaged. We've eradicated smallpox with vaccination. We've got an Ebola vaccine now, and we're on the verge of eradicating polio. And billions more people around the world have access to clean water, to sanitary toilets, which has prevented millions of deaths from waterborne diseases. Legal advancements made all of this possible. You know, if you think about it, a physician can save one life at a time, but a good public health lawyer can save hundreds, thousands, even millions of lives with one policy change. Since the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, we've literally made astounding progress in promoting health and alleviating poverty. But we're at real risk at the moment of stalling and maybe even sliding backwards. With populist governments rising in the United States and throughout the world, and the idea that each country is going to fight for itself and we're not there for each other. And that's putting us at great risk. We owe it to ourselves to reimagine and recapture what we built. And what we built was an international rules-based system where every human being has human rights and the right to health and well-being.